Okay, we're going to go over a karaoke system, and you know, you could classify it as a karaoke system, but it's more so a couple components that is designed for people that already have a really nice home system, meaning a receiver, speakers, and so forth, and all they really want to do is hook up their laptop through the system and do karaoke. So this is the solution for it. It comes with a Vocopro da1055 Pro mic mixer. And we're the first to tell you we're not a big fan of Vocopro product, but this is one product that we've been buying for our consumers for 10 years because it is this definitely is a solid mic mixer. And then you also have a dual set of Audio 2000 UHF wireless microphones with clear scan so you could change the frequencies and so forth. And then as you look in the back here, it's going to be different depending on what your system is. But I have a laptop cable here. It could look different depending on which cable's used, but for this particular customer, you have your right and left, and it's going into the CDG input. It could even go into the DVD input. So this mixer basically has two inputs that you could switch back and forth between two different devices. And then what I'm doing is I'm coming out of the mix out. What that means is I need to mix both the music and the vocals, so this goes out to the receiver. Now on the back of someone's home receiver, they have all the same RCAs. It could say DVD, CD, auxiliary, you know, BGM. Those are all identical to each other, other than they're just labeled. Now you have the wireless microphone. This wireless microphone has two antennas that you screw on. It has two volume knobs. I have it up on max right now. You could have it a little bit lower. And then it comes out with two female XLR, but you also have the ability to just come out with one quarter inch plug to go into, you know, your standard mixer and so forth. Now going back to the back of the mixer, the other end of those cables are right here, quarter inch. I plug them into mic 4 and 5. If you look at the front of the mic mixer, it does have microphone inputs on it. But to keep it as a cleaner look, that's why I plugged it in the back, and you're able to control it from here and there. So these are your individual microphone volumes. And then as you look over here, you have a set of knobs. The mic master level, then you have the lows, mid sweep and mid, and high EQ, which is for your microphones. Then just below this, you have a vocal cancel button. That's pretty much for your traditional karaoke discs, which are called multiplex, that have lead vocals. It is just for karaoke discs. You could potentially take out the vocals on a karaoke disc. Next to this is, you see, this is the source button. Going back to what I was talking about, you have two devices you could use. We have it plugged into CDG, so we have this pushed down. Then you have the echo button. That's basically just initiated so that you could hear the echo. This is a pan button. That just means left and right signal. You always keep it in the center. Then you have the echo station, which this is how much echo you're allowing to go into the microphone. And then this is a repeat and delay. Repeat basically means the echo just keeps bouncing and repeating itself. The more you bring it up, the more it does. And the delay basically puts a clamp on the effects. You'll notice that I have this all the way down and this all the way up. What that did is it makes it sound like a real tight spring where it's just a quick effects but nothing real echoey. Then you go over here. This is your main control for your music. Now there's a couple ways that you could control this. When you're going into the home receiver, your home receiver has a master volume knob that you could bring up the music utilizing that after you set this, or you could go left and right and slowly go up on the volumes. The reason why there's a left and right is there's people that set up systems where they have one speaker in one part of the room, one in the other part, and they don't want one of them to be louder than the other, and that's why this separates both channels. This has the standard button, just EQ on and off, and then you have the EQ for the left and right side. What I will tell you is play the music louder, and one of the easiest ways to figure out the best sound is to start taking each of these down. So you take this down, maybe have someone standing in the middle of the room,
and you start bringing it up, 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 until they feel that, okay, that frequency sounds a little harsh. Then you just back off of it a titch, and that should be more than good enough. It's a pretty simple system. It definitely helps where you don't have to buy a full karaoke system. And the one thing we will tell you, not all speakers are made the same. So you could have a home speaker system where the speakers sound phenomenal playing music, but they're horrible for karaoke. That just means that they don't have the proper voice coils. They cannot handle live vocals. So in the event that you run into that, it's not that this is inferior. It's just that your speaker system's not built for that. Now, touching bases on the handhelds, you'll notice that I have one open and one closed. The way this works is you unscrew this, and it reveals the battery compartment. What I would tell you is when you're putting this together, I would tell you to get Energizer rechargeable batteries. That's probably the best thing to do. And you'll notice that it slides up there. So you want to be careful. If it gets stuck, you could nudge it just a little bit to bring the battery out, or bring this further out and go ahead and bring the battery out. So when you put the first battery in, you're basically going to set it right here, clip it, slide it down, and then you're going to take the next one. Instead of clipping it here, you're going to try to clip it, bring it to the back, and then slide it in. Now, when you're powering these up, the receiver, when you power it up, you're going to push it down. In fact, I'll turn it off real quick. Okay, now it's off. You press the power button in until it lights up. Same thing with your wireless mic. Press it down until it powers up, and you'll see the numbers. Now, if for any reason you ever run into a situation where you're talking and you can't get any volume, the first thing we want you to do is check to make sure that there's no red symbol here. Because if I click this button real quick, I have the ability to put it in mute. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Click it again, it's gone. Check 1, 2. And then when you don't want to use it, power it off, hold it in until it says off.